We're all living in America. America is wunderbar.
What do you think the coolest thing about being a Muslim could be? Like, if you could be a Muslim for a day, like, why would you be a Muslim? Because they got that cool decorative, like, I mean, are you married?
Yeah.
And do you make your wife, I'm sure, you know, sometimes when you're feeling crazy and sexy, you put her in something sexy. But would you ever put her in a sheet? Well, like, it looks like they're playing Casper the Ghost.
Yeah, no.
That doesn't do much for me.
No, that's not too exciting, no.
I mean, I guess it's a great way if you don't want the rest of your bros to check out your lady. I mean, I would think that would stink. That would cause some kind of hygiene issue, maybe. And personally, I'm fat. I'm sweating right now doing this. Mm-hmm. The last thing I want over me is a damn sheet. Yeah. So, I mean, I could imagine, you know. You would think every Muslim woman in the world would be, like, climbing through your windows right now saying, please save us. So what you're saying is, by burning the Koran, you're wanting to send a message to the radical Muslims out there. And you're pretty much saying, America... And you and your church, enough's enough. We're tired of being bullied around.
Yeah, I mean, we're basically saying how far and when do we stop backing down?
How does the Mike Busey interview compare with the rest of the crazy interviews you've had?
Yeah, this is definitely one of the better ones.
But somehow, you have figured out a way to literally shake, rattle, and roll every single person from Hollywood to political. Do you even know who Angelina Jolie is? Do you know?
I know she's some kind of a movie star. Yes,
yeah,
I do.
Well, she doesn't like you. Yeah. Apparently, her and Brad Pitt have had it, and they're pretty pissed. They're not. I don't think they're going to be dropping any money in the collection plate this Sunday.
Yeah, yeah.
Something tells me they're not showing up. Like, tell me about some of the most ridiculous situations you've already literally put yourself in. Like, I mean, you've got all these people here, and you got all these, like, this help and everything. I don't know if everyone's your family or the employees or they work for the church, but, like, what? I've heard the Pope's try to contact you. Is that true? Like, what's the deal with that?
I don't know. I haven't heard from the Pope. I know that he's put out a statement against us. I guess pretty much everybody has put out a statement against us. I think it's pretty amazing that Muslims and Islam, they can drag people, missionaries, doctors, that they can stop a car, they can drag them out of the car, kill them and murder them, and it gets mentioned in the news media and then it's forgotten. But we can threaten to burn a book, and we haven't even burned a book yet. We can threaten to burn a book. Muslims freak out all around the world, and instead of the government taking our side, they're pointing the finger at us. I think it's time that we point the finger to them and tell them, stop.
We got a call, I think, 2 days ago from a retired Green Beret. He was in Yugoslavia when the Muslims did their so-called ethnic cleansing. And he saw the Muslims burn 150 churches. He saw the military stand in front of a hospital, a three-story hospital filled with Christians, as the Muslims burnt that building down, burnt those people alive, and the military, because of our policies, the military stood there and watched it happen. They were forced to. So I think when we've gone that far, then we've gone too far. Yeah. So sooner or later we've got to put a stop to it, and this is sort of our way of saying that is enough.
If you escaped out of a burning building and there was a Muslim downstairs trapped and a Jew upstairs, who would you go in if you could only go in one more time first? Who would you grab? There's a Muslim downstairs and there's a Jew upstairs. The house is on fire. You've only got enough oxygen to go in one more time. Who are you grabbing?
I guess I'd have to go for the Jew.
Ah. Fair enough. Survey says,
bing.
Shalom. Supposedly, America is not the only one that has the whole beef with the Muslims. I hear our Jewish friends aren't on their exact fan side either.
No, they hate the Jews, of course.
So I've heard.
Yes.
I've noticed you've got a really sweet mustache. How long? What's
How long you've had that? Because I'm a fan of facial hair myself,
mm-hmm.
and I haven't seen that mustache. Do you have a name for that?
No, not really.
There's about, I don't know, 1 point some odd, whatever, billion, not million, but billion Muslims out there,
yeah.
and they all are ready to kill you.
Yeah.
Is it safe to say that you're probably the most hated person on the planet right now?
I think right now that would be pretty safe to say, yes.
Like, can someone get this guy a t-shirt over here? Can we get a t-shirt, somebody? Most hated guy on the planet? Like, honestly, I don't even think Hitler even did that. Like, and he killed a bunch of Jews and did all kinds of crazy crap. And you, like, you're one of them. You haven't even burned anything.
I haven't even done any. I mean, that shows the tremendous amount of fear that we have allowed to control our lives. I mean, when was America based upon fear? I mean, weren't we based upon truth and right and wrong? Weren't we based upon courage? Were we not at one time a nation willing to die for what is right? I think this whole thing has revealed the tremendous amount of fear that is in America.
They've called it something now. They're calling it Muslim phobia or whatever they're calling it now.
Yeah, yeah, right.
It's almost created a new word, a new terminology.
Right, right.
You know? I think had you done this maybe a couple weeks or maybe a month after September 11, 2001, I don't think we'd even be here right now.
That's probably true.
I don't think the Pope would be calling. I don't think Barack Obama. If someone tells me not to do something, that's the worst thing in the world. And I'm hard-headed. And I'm not saying you're hard-headed, but it's gone beyond any of that. It's now about principle.
Mm-hmm.
It's not. I don't even think it's about religion or beliefs. It's about your rights and America. Like, there's people burning flags.
Yep.
There are people burning Bibles. And I don't want to see that. But you don't see me coming up to them, saying crazy stuff to them. You don't see me making death threats. You know, like, that's it makes me disgusted. And that's a beautiful thing. There's a lot of things that probably make everyone disgusted in this beautiful country. But the thing that's most beautiful about it is that you can do what you want. You have that freedom to exercise those rights.
Right.
And it's beyond me because honestly I haven't seen anyone stand beside you on any of this whole entire time. Like, have you had any, like, I mean, other than like far as media, I think that they'll get fired if they say that. Oh yeah, burn the Korans. Oh hey, don't put that on camera. Like, do you think some of them secretly are like all about it? They can't say that because they're scared, you know, they'll...
I think there's some of them that probably are, because we've had that here. We have actually had people come by here who have jobs with large companies, and they say, we agree with you. We agree with the message. We agree with how bad and evil Islam is, but we can't say anything. Yeah. This is in America. We can't say anything because if we do, we will be fired. I think if one thing that this thing has done, if nothing else, it has brought an awareness to the evil of Islam. Like you said, the imam there in New York, all they did was ask him, well, maybe we could move the mosque a couple of blocks further away. That was all they asked. They didn't even ask him to cancel it. They didn't threaten him. They said, why don't we move it a couple blocks farther away? And he came with threats. And he said, well, that will not be interpreted properly in the Muslim world, and there might be reactions, and there might be terrorism. That's how far we've come as America. We are no longer standing up. We are bowing down.
God bless. From the shitstorm that is Burn the Koran Day, the verdict is in. The Muslims have thrown in the towel. It's official. The Muslims have given up. The mosque is moving to NYC. You heard it first here on MikeBusey.com. Inmate Art, back to you in the studio.
I don't know, man. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with a light from above, from the mountains.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mike Busey, and that's how you report the motherfucking news.
White with fire.